today's video, I want to drill out a hard steel wheel bolt for a friend. The locking wheel bolts on this vehicle have been damaged and cannot be removed using the dedicated anti-theft wheel bolt remover. The garage has managed to remove 3 locking wheel bolts, but could not remove this one. The tyre is getting very close to being dangerous, and so this wheel has to come off in order to change the tyre, even if it means cutting the alloy wheel off with the grinder. I'd just like to point out that drilling the wheel bolt should be the last resort. Normally with something like this, I would try and weld a steel pipe to the end of the wheel bolt. But I only had galvanized pipe, which is not good to weld. I then tried to tap the bolt out using a cold chisel and hammer, but that proved impossible. I have done a video showing several techniques on how to remove rounded bolts, etc. I will put a link to that in the description. If you are going to try welding something to the wheel bolt, it is critical to disconnect the negative lead on the car's battery terminal, or you can fry the electrics when you start welding. It is also important to loosen the other bolts on the wheel slightly before attempting to remove the difficult one. To drill out a hard wheel bolt like this, you are going to need some specialist equipment, mainly a magnetic based drill and a special drill bit for hardened steel. In this video, I'm using an Evolution mag based drill. This makes really light work of drilling metal. You can see that in order to use the drill, I have clamped a mild steel plate to the wheel. Then the mag based drill is held onto the plate using the electromagnet on the base of the mag based drill. By using this drill bit, you can ensure that you get the drill bit right in the centre of the bolt. I borrowed this mag based drill from a friend, but you can often hire them quite cheaply. To do the drilling, I want to use these, which are R2 drill bits from the Profit line. These are multi-purpose drill bits, so you have what looks like a regular drill bit, and at the end there it looks like a masonry bit. That has a very tough piece of tungsten carbide, which is welded into the end of that, and that is very, very tough. These drill bits can actually be used to drill through a steel bearing race, which is one of the toughest steels that you can actually get. You do have to use these drill bits on a very high speed. For that reason, you need to use them in either a mag-based drill or a pillar drill when you are drilling steels. It's not recommended to use these on mild steel because that is too soft. Obviously, you can drill mild steel with a regular HSS drill bit. And as you can see, that one really needs re-grinding at the end there. Another thing you could use is a solid carbide bit, but solid carbide bits like that are very expensive and they are very brittle. Any sideways movement at all on that bit will cause it to break. So really, solid carbide bits like that should really only be used in machine shops or in places where you can ensure that the drill bit is not going to wander at all, because that will break it. The first drill bit is roughly a 5mm diameter bit. You have no chance of drilling a hard wheel nut using a standard HSS or cobalt drill bit, as you will blunt the drill as soon as you touch the bolt. You will notice that I'm not using any cutting fluid or coolant. This is because these drill bits do not require any. These bits actually work better if the metal gets hot. You can see that the drilled out metal on the floor is burnt, which is exactly what you want with these drill bits. The heat generated during the drilling process can also help to loosen the damaged bolt. Once I have drilled down the bolt using this bit, I swap it over to the 10mm diameter bit and continue drilling. I am ensuring that I do not go all the way through the wheel bolt, as I do not want to drill anything other than the bolt. I have removed one of the other wheel bolts and used masking tape to gauge the correct drilling depth. Once the main diameter of the bolt is drilled out, I then try to knock the bolt loose again using a cold chisel and a hammer. You can see that this time the bolt has loosened and can be removed by chasing the bolt out with the hammer and chisel. If it was not possible to chase this out with a hammer and chisel, another option would have been to use a screw extractor or drill the wheel bolt out completely and then clean the hole using a tap. This is the drilled wheel bolt. As you can see, the hole is straight down the centre of the bolt. When replacing the wheel bolts, it's a really good idea to add some anti-seize compound to the bolts, as this will hopefully prevent this from happening again. I hope you found this video useful. If you have and you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel.